翻嚟本港，行政長官李家超話，多項輸入人才計劃截至上個月底批出近180,000宗，有超過120,000人已經抵港。
疫情後，香港積極搶人才，推出了高才通計劃，亦都繼續有不同的項目，包括優秀人才入境計劃、科技人才入境計劃、非本地畢業生留港回港就業安排、輸入中國籍香港永久居民第二代計劃。行政長官李家超話，截至四月底，當局收到一共大約290,000份申請，當中近180,000份獲批，超過120,000人才已經抵港。李家超同劳福局局长孙玉涵等同来港的国家人力资源和社会保障部部长黄晓平会面，就吸引全球人才同深化两地人才协作等的议题交换意见。李家超说会继续深化内地同香港人才合作，推动职业技能人才培养同资格互认，继续促进人才互联互通。孙玉涵就出席了由至少40新来港企业家组成的新质企业家联合会创立典礼，认为是抢人才的新里程碑。
对吗？就是他们来的不光是说为香港现有的经济发展，而是为香港的将来带来新的想法，带来新的创意，而且为香港很多香港本地的人创造很多岗位。香港最大的优势就是我们一国两制的制度优势这个是独一无二的但是要发挥好这个制度优势离不开人。
身兼联合会秘书长的立法会议员尚海龙说，透过多场高才通招聘会，发现本港侧重金融地产等人才来到香港想投身其他的行业有一定难度，希望来自人工智能、新能源业界等的成员企业可以为香港带来新机遇。无线电视记者李卓谦报道。
白香锦田公路一个男工人怀疑遭到跌落嚟的铁板击中，送院救治，证实死亡。劳工处调查意外原因。事发在锦田公路8号，警员到场调查。警方话，寻日下昼6点接获货仓负责人报案，话一个32岁的男工人协助运送铁板期间，遭到由高处滑落的铁板击中头，当场昏迷，由救护车送博爱医院抢救，证实死亡，警方列作工业意外处理。一架私家车在青衣撞博，司机额头受伤，清醒送院。私家车的车头严重损毁，挡风玻璃碎裂。凌晨3点几，私家车沿青衣北桥往机场方向行驶，去到青衣城对开一条分叉路失控，撞向路中的防撞栏，反弹撞向路边石驳。司机爬出车厢，救护员接报到场，将伤者送院治理。现场消息话，司机怀疑身有酒气，警方调查事故原因。转睇下，福建发现全球最大型恐爪龙类的恐龙足迹，估计身长达到5米。一起睇下。
由中国地质大学北京等组成的联合科考队，4年前在福建龙岩市龙翔大道附近发现大规模的晚白鳄世恐龙足迹群，亦都是福建第一次发现恐龙存在的证据。经过几年研究之后，团队发现多种恐龙足迹，有5个是恐爪龙大型足迹，平均长36.4厘米，宽16.9厘米，可以组成一道痕迹，是目前世界已知的最大恐爪龙类足迹。
你看到这个比较小的一个圆坑，这个是它的第二个指头，它的脚上有3个指头。这一类恐龙足迹原来非常小，这是第一次发现这么大的一个状态，所以在对研究恐龙演化很有意义。
恐爪龙是生活于侏罗纪晚期至白垩纪的肉食或者杂食兽脚类恐龙，行嗰阵会在地上面留下翼子形足印。新发现的足迹被命名为英良福建足迹。研究团队说，今次发现对中国晚白垩世恐龙动物群的研究具有重要意义。无线电视记者曹嘉荣报道。
文汇报社评， 金融管理局寻日公布香港外汇基金第一季投资收益是543亿，外汇基金连续两季录得净收益，进一步增强港元汇率和金融体系稳定，同时减咗少少财政压力，对政府放心全力拼经济亦是个鼓励。当然，未来市场存在较大波动性，受美国经济走势和减息步伐和中东地缘政治影响大，外汇基金投资收益增长只能够审慎乐观。外汇基金亦都可以在保本增值的前提之下加大投资创科步伐，助力香港增强经济动能。东方日报社评，港府说食肆业务去年大幅反弹之后，在今年第一季增幅放缓，展望所推出措施加强信心，加上访港旅游业复苏和就业收入上升，应该会继续支持食肆业务。第一季食肆有少的升幅，但走势放缓，不多不少，正正反映饮食业步入艰难期。今个五一假期访港的内地旅客大部分是个人游，人均消费力减少超过两成，加上入境旅行团大多不是高端团，他们来港的消费力不高，或者可以说是消费意欲不高，双重夹击之下，对餐饮业更加难免构成颇大的挑战。香港原本就是美食之都，难道随着港人北上消费成大趋势而一去不复返？
又到中华丽影时间，随着航天事业发展，太空肉种越来越常见。这些太空种子翻返地面后会怎样处理呢？一起去了解一下。
在甘肃兰州肉种基地，被称为牧草之王的牧畜，产量高，草质优良。原来都是用太空种子培育的国家级新品种，通常要用约十年的时间研究。
首先我们要进行地面筛选，对种子返回的种子，我们在地面种植之后筛选出有益的突变单株，我们进行连续四代到六代的选育研究，之后等它性状稳定，比如说高产，比如说是它的蛋白质含量高，这样的特性稳定之后，我们要经过品种比较实验，也就是说是我们要和其他的现有的市场推广的品种进行做比较，看它的优势在哪里，之后再进行区域实验，在不同地区进行种植和同时进行生产实验。
而山东青岛亦都有太空种子培育的芹菜，因为品质好，非常畅销。
目前我们航马二号在田间的表现比较均一，产量比较稳定，亩产在10000斤左右，然后色泽黄绿，空心脆筋，特别好吃。相较于传统的马家沟芹菜，航马二号芹香味更加浓郁，但是产量稍有不足，品质更好。去年我们马家沟芹菜销往了全国各地，一年的销售量在400吨左右。
专家预计未来会实现批量化航天育种。无线电视记者陈宇桥报道。
气温回升，位于中俄边境的黑龙江呼玛县河冰消融，当地就举办开江主题文化活动，吸引不少游客参加。一起看看。
在呼玛县这条江，河冰融化成为冰牌，顺江而下，各地游客纷纷来到观景。
黑龙江呼玛的这个开江跑冰牌是非常有特色的，每年我都会跑到这里来，等待着看开江的这个壮观的景象。而且它还有很多活动，比如说吃江鱼，晚上的篝火晚会，
亦都有俄罗斯游客作画留念。当地亦都举办开江主题文化周，品尝江鱼是开江仪式重头戏，游客围绕在七个窝品尝。
我们准备的有很多鱼，有鲤鱼，有那个牛尾鱼炖小米粥，有鲶鱼炖茄子，有鲫鱼炖豆腐，还有我们特别重视的一个重重鱼，这个鱼非常那个细嫩柔软。
今年是中俄文化年，在鹿鼎山景区亦都有一系列文化交流活动。
特别喜欢今天的表演，今天中国舞蹈演员、中国歌手，还有我非常喜欢今天俄罗斯演员也可以参加这样的好的节目。我非常喜欢，我爱中国。
活动期间亦都有中俄农创产品展销会等。无线电视记者郑希年报道。
呢节中华丽景报道完。
早晨，港股强，美股都强啊！港股大家知道啦，喂，升升下就连升十日噶咯，累积计咧，我升咗成2300多点。咁啊，睇外围配唔配合咧，我哋今日走势先。美股咧，听提到咧都强势啊嘛，继续咧就炒呢个减息憧憬啊。咁日前咧，因为我大家知道啦，上星期五咧，自从咧就业数据咁反映到咧就劳工市场咧系有几个指标都系偏软之后咧，大家咧系又憧憬翻今年咧美国有机会减息两次。咁科技股特别醒神啦，要炒减息。咁三大指数琴日当然都升嘅，道指就升四日啦，标普五百同埋纳指咧就连升三日。刚才提到啦，科技股劲啊嘛，其实纳指咧你睇睇下咧，哇连续两日啦，企翻上50天移动平均线。个纳指咧，其实你睇翻收市价咧，去翻16300啊，即系唔止上翻50天线噶啦。一之前咧，佢个高位就16500啊嘛，你琴日收16300咧，其实慢慢已经试翻个顶噶啦。咁当然加埋内地股市做好带动之下咧，咁睇提到啦，港股升咗十日，今朝早咧就轻微低开一点，仲系几硬净，唔系好肯回吐。最新情况点样咧？唔使等啦，即刻睇睇好嘛。最新就跌58点，都唔系跌好多啫。最新18522点。咁金融指数啊，地产指数仲撑得住，但系点解会个市即系个指数会跌咧？咁样，因为今朝早咧有啲股份啊，譬如好似只重磅股阿里巴巴啊、腾讯咧，都系略为低开啊嘛。但系只友邦就轻微高开5毫子，63蚊，一个月高位，即系重磅蓝筹咧都有升有跌，暂时扯住咧个指数喺18500水平，即系轻微偏软，成交有43亿几。好啦，呢个时间再睇睇一个期货走势啦。五月份咧跌紧76点，18400水平，咁啊暂时咧就略为低水啦。咁啊成交有6700多张。咁啊内地股市稍微补充下啦，上证、深证咧琴日好强啦，都系再创今年以嚟嘅高位。即系当然琴日啱啱复市啦，系创今年以嚟嘅高位。今朝早系低开一点嘅啫，啊同港股一致，只系轻微低开。今朝早内地 A 股咧炒金属股啊、体育股同埋医疗器械，当然阵间再跟吓。好睇埋咧汇约港股最新嘅情况啦，排第一位腾讯股价跌8毫子。咁啊，只中国平安咧升2毫，39.35。友邦咦倒跌翻少少，倒跌翻3毫子，去翻62.2。美团跌2.7，跌幅2%。新洲跌2.5毫子。咁啊，成班得平保系靠稳嘅啫。咁啊，第六位阿里巴巴都系偏软啦，跌1%。咁啊，汇通达网络咧报29.9，咁啊只牛仔啊上咗榜，报3.8嘅。咁啊，快手咧今朝就开头都好似 OK 嘅，但系而家最新咧就跌翻2%，60.65毫半嘅。咁啊，快手咧其实都啲浸喺新经济股里边咧都系弹得快嗰啲吓。咁当然仲有商汤啦，咁啊就升咗唔少啦。咁最新股价升1.7%，做紧1.71，继续喺翻佢近排嘅高台附近拉锯紧嘅。咁啊，讲起啲新经济股咧，假如要报埋个恒生科技指数啦，最新微跌40点，做3966点。咁啊，焦点股咧睇内房先啊，因为内地咧又有啲扶持楼市嘅措施啦，咁样。咁啊，之前咧即系政治局会议，大家睇紧啊，点样去消化啲库存咧，即系消化啲货尾咧，有啲新嘅建议出嚟咁样啦，大家有憧憬喺度啦。咁啊，最新咧要睇个别地区啦，就系、是、深圳咧系放宽7个区域啊嘅楼市限制。咁啊，最主要系限购啦，即系之前有啲限制措施系即系等你冇咁容易买到楼嘅，但系而家呢啲限购咧就有啲放宽啦，喺深圳7个区域咧就做呢样嘢。咁部分嘅家庭咧可以喺某啲区系再买多一层楼。咁大摩认为咧，当然个放宽力度咧，其实睇完呢个措施，觉得系细过预期嘅。咁只系放宽咗啲非核心区嘅啫。咁估计咧，对于刺激嘅楼市嘅成交咧，就作用咧都系轻微嘅啫。咁当然暂时咧个股价咧，而家暂时望落去咧都系多数升嘅。咁万科升得好啲啦，咁升幅咧有超过1%。嗰万科都有数据，四月份嘅合同销售额咧接近209亿人民币，按年倒退超过37%嘅，即系卖楼差咗啦。咁但系呢啲应该系市场预期之内啦，因为好多间都差。咁啊，雅居乐都有数，四月份咧预售金额咧就11.9亿人民币，按年咧仲跌得多啊，按年咧就卖楼少咗68%。咁暂时股价咧就冇喐动嘅。 好啦，咁啊，睇睇內地嘅消費類股份，所謂內需股啦。高盛有報告啊，咁最新報告提到咧，內地五一假期，咁啊，相比舊年咧一個比較好高嘅基數底下咧，其實整體嘅消費都算係咁啦嚇。舊年成績都 OK 嘅啦，啊，今年咧就喺咁嘅成績之上咧，都仲做得好咁樣，消費情況健康。咁主要係受到咧旅遊相關消費帶動。咁睇翻期內咧遊客量按年升咗超過7%，咁相等於疫情前，即係2019年嘅1.28倍，咁令到咧就旅遊消費增加了12%左右，等于疫情前是1.1倍的水平。当然讲那么多，高盛简单来讲都是觉得消费 OK 啦，但是望啲内需股有升有跌的。好啦，咁睇睇啲煤炭类相关啦。大摩有报告提到咧，煤炭价格普遍咧按周系有得升，其中秦皇岛港口嘅库存咧就按个星期系跌咗3%左右，环渤海港口嘅煤嘅库存咧都跌咗0.6%。通常咧啲库存跌咧，即系表示供应少咗啲啦，应该系有利嗰啲煤价嘅。咁但系要留意翻，因为内地咧上个月尾咪有落咗好多雨嘅吓，强降雨，咁令到咧内地多个嘅水坝嘅水位上升，預期咧透過水力發電嘅供電量咧係亦都係增加咗嘅，咁可能咧會抵消咧對於煤熱電嘅需求都未頂，即係有好亦都有利淡嘅因素。咁但係總之煤股咧暫時都向好嘅，咁其中係中國神華咧靠穩啦，鉛礦好啲啦，升幅咧挨近2%。下晝再傾啦。
各位，行政长官李家超在香港全球人才高峰会致开幕词，看看现场情况啦。
陈李文 of the Guangdong Provincial Government, Director General 杜敏琪 of the Guangdong Provincial Government, Secretary General 焦壮行 of the Talent Development Committee of the Macau SAR Government, Distinguished Guests.Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Hong Kong. And welcome to the inaugural Global Talent Summit organized by the Hong Kong SAR government. And what an inaugural summit this is, with three high-powered, talent-driven events over these next 2 days.Today's International Talent Forum, tomorrow's Guangdong, Hong Kong, Macau, Greater Bay Area High Quality Talent Development Conference, and running both days, a Career Connect Expo featuring nearly 100 exhibitions. Then there's you, the most important element of all, each and every one of you. Some 1,000 participants from around the world are here for the summit. More than 2,500 others have registered for online participation. And Hong Kong is at the very heart of it all. The central government has always been the strongest supporter of Hong Kong. And of yesterday, I'm pleased to note, the mainland has expanded.The talent exit endorsement. That means mainland professionals in scientific research, education, healthcare, legal practice, and other areas from Beijing, Shanghai, and 9 Greater Bay Area cities can travel to and from Hong Kong multi times within the validity period of their exit endorsement. The new policy.Will make it more convenient for mainland professionals to travel to Hong Kong. It will also promote professional exchanges and reinforce Hong Kong's role as the country's international talent hub and gateway for Greater Bay Area professionals. My thanks to the Ministry of Human Resources and Social Security for its continuing support. My thanks to Minister Wang Xiaoping.For leading a delegation to the Global Talent Summit. Why is talent significant to economic growth? Talent is the prime resource and driving force that boosts economic development and competitiveness. Strategic professionals generate the innovative ideas that lead to new and improved products, services, and technologies. Talent is also driven by hunger for personal growth, to excel in their fields and push the boundaries of their abilities. These elements are key factors in success, not just for professionals and their industries, but more important, the success of the overall economy. With much of the world working to revive economic growth in the post-pandemic global economy and amid rising geopolitical tensions, the search for talent has become a global phenomenon and a continuous challenge. Why Hong Kong? Why relocate here? Because Hong Kong is where talent gets to thrive and grow in a world-class economy, in Asia's world city. Thanks to our One Country, Two Systems principle, Hong Kong is bestowed with prime business prospects and far-reaching promise. Hong Kong is the only place in the world where the global advantage and China advantage come together in a single city. We have the foundation well in place to succeed. Hong Kong's institutional strengths include a world-class business environment, a simple and low-tax system, a highly open and internationalized market, and the free flow of information, capital, goods, and people. These strengths are buttressed by the rule of law and the long-standing common law system, which is similar to that practiced in many major international financial centers around the world. Alongside our international financial and trade prowess, we are emerging as an innovation and technology hub and cultural metropolis. Hong Kong was ranked first in Asia, second globally, among the world's top 100 emerging startup ecosystems, according to the latest Global Startup Ecosystem Report. Hong Kong, let me add, is much more than a city of businesses and skyscrapers. We have long been one of Asia's most livable cities. For newcomers, communication is never a problem. We have always been a bilingual community, a city where English and Chinese are official languages. It will only become even more multilingual as Hong Kong continues to thrive as an East meets West center for cultural exchange. Hong Kong is a splendid and diverse mix of Eastern and Western cultures, home to world-class arts and sports events. Hong Kong is also blessed with natural beauty. Some 40% of our territory is given over to country parks with endless hiking trails, stunning beaches, and even a UNESCO Global Geopark. And our location at the heart of Asia means you can get anywhere in good time. It helps too that we are an international aviation hub. Our healthcare services are world-class in quality, efficiency, and reliability. Hong Kong is also among the world's safest cities. In Hong Kong, you don't just get world-class work opportunities, you get a satisfying life too. Yes, choosing to relocate to Hong Kong on your own or with your loved ones is a big decision. But I'm here to tell you that this is the place where you can work hard, play hard, and enjoy hard. The Hong Kong SAR government invests heavily in attracting, developing, and retaining talent. Hong Kong is the only Asian city with as many as 5 universities in the world's top 100. And let me add, Hong Kong's universities are home to some of the world's top 10 schools, covering such disciplines as dentistry, nursing, education, data science, and AI, according to the latest QS World University rankings. No less important, our doors and our arms are wide open to talents from all over the world. Since launching a series of talent admission programs at the end of 2022, we have welcomed more than 120,000 talents from around the world, talents who have settled in Hong Kong. Many more will follow, of that I'm confident. While the government is taking the lead to attract companies and talented individuals to Hong Kong, the private sector has an important role to play in strengthening our talent base. In this regard, I wish to invite you all to pay tribute to the late Professor Tang Xiao'ou 教授, Professor Tang Xiao'ou. Professor Tang was a distinguished leader in our business. He's also a distinguished leader in our business community as well, and was a member of my Council of Advisors. He had tendered valuable advice to me in the areas of innovation and entrepreneurship, and his untimely passing was indeed a loss for Hong Kong. A computer scientist and a pioneer in the field of AI, he was among the first few in promoting the commercialization of R&D outcomes in Hong Kong. Some of his outstanding achievements include the founding of the Chinese University of Hong Kong's MM Lab, and of course, the founding of Hong Kong's first homegrown unicorn to be listed on our very own stock exchange. No less vital was his vision and dedication in working with youth and grooming young talents. He mentioned numerous ideas and mentored numerous outstanding AI talents here in Hong Kong and on the mainland. Professor Tong's vision, determination, and leadership will continue to inspire us all. For the business leaders and educators among us today, we need you. If we are to nurture, attract, and inspire talents, if we are to take full advantage of the flourishing future here for Hong Kong and for everyone, we need your full support. Hong Kong Talent Engage, an office set up under our Labour and Welfare Bureau, is dedicated to creating targeted recruitment and publicity for strategic international and mainland talent. Talent Engage also provides a wide ranging of support services for incoming professionals, from job hunting, apartment and school searches, to banking services and networking. That includes, of course, the hosting of this inspiring summit just a few months after its own good launch. I'm pleased to note that the Talent Engage is working closely with like-minded partners in supporting talent. These partners include the Hong Kong Top Talent Services Association, the Hong Kong Quality and Talent Migrants Association, the Bay Area Economic and Trade Association, and the latest addition to the list, the Hong Kong New Quality Entrepreneur Union, established just yesterday. My thanks to the Human Resources and Social Security Department of the Guangdong Province, as well as the Hong Kong and Macau Affairs Office of Guangdong Province and the Talent Development Committee of the Macau SAR Government. They are with us today and are also the organizers of tomorrow's Greater Bay Area Conference, the second edition following last year's inaugural event in Guangzhou. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish you all the best of business at the Global Talent Summit. And do take full advantage of your stay with us in Hong Kong. Embrace a wide ranging of museums, galleries, hiking trails, and beaches. then indulge in our international celebrated wine and dine scene. This is how you can play hard after working hard in the conferences, and also spend hard in this gourmet city and shopping paradise. Enjoy the summit and all that's on offer in Hong Kong. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Executive. Please take a seat.
各位，行政長官李家超是出席香港全球人才高峰會至開幕時的。剛剛就講到來自大灣區新增了北京、上海的內地科研、教育等多方面的人才，已經可以是更容易辦理來港和可以多次來到香港參與會議等等的。而在一國兩制之下，香港是背向祖國面向世界，香港是有很多的優勢便利到人才發展，包括是創科等等，同埋進行文化交流等嘅活動，並且係推動到香港嘅經濟發展，同時係加強本港嘅競爭力噶。至於輸入人才方面啦，截至上月底已經係批出咗近180,000宗嘅申請，現時係有超過120,000人啦，已經係嚟咗香港噶啦。又話本港係有5大學位列喺世界前百名，亦都係為本港培育出唔同嘅範疇人才。現場情況先看到這裡，我們轉看國際消息。一節最新的消息，衛生署7月開始調整牙科診所服務，由當日凌晨12點提早至到前一晚8時開始排籌。一個女人昨日中午在尖沙咀街頭被人掳走，警方夜晚在馬鞍山恆安村找回她。消息指警方拘捕3個懷疑涉案男人。有市民拍攝到女事主被掳走的過程，兩個戴住鴨嘴帽和口罩、穿著黑色上衣和長褲的男人將女事主挟持上私家車。事發在昨日中午，多個市民報警說私家車往旺角方向逃去，大批警員封鎖漢口道，宜昌街交界調查，也有探員去到附近的店鋪查看閉路電視。警方夜晚在恆安村恆月樓對開發現涉案的私家車，47女事主留在车上，她并没有受伤，案件列作非法禁锢调查。转头回来再看其他消息。